Hi, I'm Henry Segerman.
And I'm Sabetta Matsumoto.
And this is a gear cube.
And this is a brain gear.
So these are both mechanisms that use bevel gears to make them work. So ordinary planar gears, the axles around which the gears rotate are parallel to each other.
Whereas in bevel gears have a conical shape so that all of the axles can meet at a vertex or a point like this.
So on the gear cube, there were 8 bevel gears around this, and they're all meeting in the center of the cube.
And in the brain gear, there are 6 places where 4 axles meet.
One of the really cool things about this design is that opposite bevel gears do exactly the same thing. So these two here that Sabetta's pointing at, it's as if they're rigidly connected together. Well, and what that means is I could just hold it by these two. They're not going to move relative to each other. And then I can rotate the other 6 bevel gears around them.
So the brain gear is based on an octahedron. So here's one of the vertices, and here's 3 of the vertices. The other 3 are behind, and each of these conical gear pairs runs along the edge of the octahedron. So if we look at one of the vertices of this brain gear, as I rotate things back and forth, the left and the right gears meeting at this vertex rotate in the same sense, whereas the top and bottom ones rotate in the opposite sense.
So that's relevant to the question of, could you make a brain gear based on a different shape, not an octahedron, but some other polyhedron? Well, if the condition is that the number of edges meeting at each vertex has to be even, that's pretty restrictive. So there's a similar restriction on the gear cube. If you wanted to do a gear some other polyhedron, what do you need? Well, you need that every face has an even number of gears because they alternate which direction they go.
So you'll note that the octahedron is dual to the cube. And since they have the same combinatorics, you can kind of see how this works. So every vertex in the octahedron is dual to a face in the cube. So if I have 4 around this vertex, I have 4 around this face.
So the cube, you can generalize to something, maybe the truncated octahedron, which is made of squares and hexagons, both even 4s and 6s. And so whatever the dual of that is, presumably you could make a brain gear based on that shape.
Question for the audience. We just talked about how we need to have cycles that have even numbers of gears, but here I have a triangle. So 1 edge, 2 edge, 3 edge, each of these has a gear. So why does this motion work? This is a brain gear.
And this is the gear cube.
Thanks for watching.